and they were coming with late doubles. They were stopping his penetration and really going, and they were creating a lot of stuff off their defense. You'll see here again, quick pass into Alley Peak, but still a turnover coming off of the block shot. Again, denying the penetration. And then another one here, pass off to Castro again, penetrating, but denied again. And then you'll see the last one here on the great defense coming through against Jimmy. Long shot, leads to long rebounds, and who's going to run out and get in front? Danny Ildefonso, the oldest guy on the floor with a finish. And you know, they took Renny Del Campo out right after that.
Well, second quarter, it was all about a loaded comeback for the Talking Tex Trouble and Texers. You're talking about Jimmy Alapag here really starting things off along with Ryan Reyes.
Right, hitting a couple long jumpers. They were down 13 at this point. Jimmy scores, is responsible for the next 7 points. And then he gets Renny Del involved. Six straight points by Renny Del Campo that brought him even closer. And then to finish the half. Nice play here. Kick to Alley Peak, late on the rotation. Jump shot, suddenly it's an 8-point lead. Talking Tex shot 38 points in that second shot, second quarter, and shot 67% from the field. Sam McGill was losing their defensive discipline in that second quarter.
Well, Jimmy Alapag right now leading the charge for the Talking Texers with 12 points, combined with the 20 points of Randy Del Campo and Ryan Reyes combined. And then on the other side, you have Dondon Ontiveros, who always is very effective from the outside, and then Jay Washington and Arwin Santos. But there was some time that you noticed, Coach Jim, that San Miguel was just falling in love with their outside shots.
Yes, and Dondon hit a couple of threes to keep them close, keep them a little bit ahead, but by and large, you know, they started falling in love with that. Jay Wash hit a couple. Arwin threw up a couple, and that led to quick transitions and baskets the other way around. They're going to have to get back. If I'm Otto Augustin, I'm telling my guys, hey, you've got to get back to the discipline of playing that first quarter. Let's get focused on defense. Let's attack the basket like Arwin's been doing the last couple of games. Let's bring that to the second half.
That said, Miguel, what about for Talking Tex? What adjustments do you want to see?
Hey, Chad is happy. He's really happy. I mean, he's seeing exactly what they want to do. They're getting the penetration off the guards. He's freeing Jimmy Alapag up and forcing double teams. Jimmy's making great decisions. It's all going Talking Tex away right now.
All right. Well, we'll break down the half more for you when Nico Halili and the Dean Canito Henson come back after this break.
Well, there's been a lot of action, a lot of running, a lot of hugging. This is a very physical game number 5 of the PBA Philippine Cup Finals sa labang po ang Talking Tex. Best scoring quarter of Talking Tex in the series. Yan ang nakita natin in the second period.
You know, the way Talking Tex played this first half, it was like night and day. It was night in the first quarter when they scored only 14 points. And then it was day in the second quarter when they scored 38. And you take a look at the Dean's list here for Talking Tex. Jumping the gun, it's all check marks. They've been able to rule the boards. They were aggressive from the outset, getting more free throw attempts, and they've been able to deny the crunch man who's not scored a single point in this game. That's Alex Cabagnon. And for San Miguel, cracking the whip. Well, that's supposed to be predicated on defense. They did the job defensively in the first quarter, not in the second quarter. They haven't been able to protect the interior. You see the second chance points that Talking Tex has scored. What about baiting the mousetrap to do things that he's not used to? That's not happening. Jimmy Alapag already with 12 points and 6 assists. Being one step ahead, that's also not happening because San Miguel has turned the ball over a lot more times than Talking Tex so far.
Nice idea there para kay Ronnie Bell. Arwin blocking the shot of Ali Peak. Here comes Artadi. Artadi over to Washington. Hands high.
Artadi able to get the ball up close to Jay Washington.
Starting the second half para sa Talking Tex, Randall Del Campo, Jimmy Alapag, Ali Peak, Jason Castro, Ryan Reyes. Here's Castro. Ryan Reyes from the corner. Battle for the rebound. Oh, Ryan Reyes with those quick hands. Pero tumama sa linya. Good hustle nonetheless. Bola na San Miguel. Para naman sa San Miguel Beerman on the floor. Paul Artadi, Arwin Santos, Daniel Defonso, Dondon Ontiveros, and Jay Washington. 6 points sa kabante ng Talking Text. The miss by Danny Ai. Here's Castro. Castro reverse layup is good.
More inside points pouring in for Talking Text.
You know, if there was any doubt that the Talking Text was ready for this game as Washington on courts, the Talking Text was ready to reclaim control of the series. That second quarter proved the readiness of the Tropang Texters.
You know, in the same way, Nico, that we saw in game number 4, the 1-2 punch of San Miguel was Arwin Santos and Jay Washington. Right now, we're seeing Castro and Alapag, the 1-2 punch of Talking Text.
And for more on Talking Text, here's Dominic.
Well, Coach Short Reyes reminded his boys to stick to the game plan, and that's to break down the defense, move the ball, and get open looks. He's happy that they shot really well in the second quarter. Also, he said, Ali, you got to keep on fighting and keeping your presence inside.
Well, Alapag is still shooting, still fighting. Alapag now with 14 points to lead the way for the Tropang Texters. Back inside the big dome, Arwin Santos missing it. Offensive rebound, Washington challenge that may foul sa ilalim.
Nico, I want to be able to raise up a point here. Oh, before that, let's turn it over to Chicky.
Chicky, what do you have for us?
Thanks, Nico. You know, credit Talking Text's blue-collar worker attitude for San Miguel's collapse in the second quarter. This was what Coach Ato told me during their huddle at the half. Yes, the players will give order to their game, but if they do not have the energy and if they allow Talking Text to outwork them, then this game will slip from their hands. Now, he also added that they cannot relax after building a good lead, as Talking Text will surely recover. Nico?
Yan ang mga nakalat ni Chicky from Ato Agustin. By the way, shares the same birthday as Talking Text head coach Short Reyes. And it says something about boys and girls, we're going to learn about fire rhythms.
Well, you know, Nico, I was saying, I wasn't surprised when this series got tied 2-2 because this series is so evenly matched. And probably one reason is because the opposing coaches have the same birthday, August 1, 1963. Both of them are 47 years old. You're talking about fire rhythm. One can't catch the other on a low plane when the other one is on a high because they have the same birthdays. So they're always going to be both on a high or they're going to be both on a low. That's why we have an evenly matched series. Logical, by the way.
Well, it certainly helps with the analysis. Hindi naman yung apektado, di ba nagbago yung zodiac sign bigla?
Oh, ma. I wanted to introduce it as a point of trivia because I don't think we've ever seen any finals confrontations in the PBA ever where the opposing coaches have the same exact birthdays. Can you believe it?
Eh, bira na nga yung parehong edad. Di ba? Ay, yung ating chairman of the board, Rene Pardo, wants to greet his grandson, Miguel Pardo, who turns 10 today. Yeah, happy birthday, Miguel. Hope you're enjoying the game. Meantime, Radadel offensive rebound. Shot lock, Arwin Santos, pero may foul.
Well, that time, three defenders for San Miguel, making sure that there would be no easy basket for Radinel Do Campo. But the Cardinals in there was giving up an offensive opportunity for Talking Text off the missed free throw.
Third person in laban kay Jay Washington. That's why Radinel is on the line. First free throw rattles out. But Radinel had that big second quarter as you look at Commissioner Attorney Chief to salute.
A lot of people are asking, which team is hungrier, San Miguel Beer or Talking Text? Last Philippine Cup championship of Talking Text was back in 08-09 with Coach Short Reyes. And the last Philippine Cup championship of San Miguel was back in 2001. Matatagal na yun. But of course, San Miguel did win the 08-09 Fiesta Conference title. That was with Coach Short Tampinsen.
Oh, look out. This will be a turnover. Eight and 33 remaining. This is the third quarter. If you just joined us, in the opening quarter, it was all San Miguel. They led by as many as 9 points. They were very confident, very fluid. Samantalang ang Talking Text naman, they seem very tight. Seem to have been affected by the pressure in the opening quarter, but in the second period, it was all Talking Text, and they scored big in that period to grab the lead from San Miguel.
I think it was all cylinders flowing for Talking Text in the second quarter. You had the guards doing a lot of damage offensively and then running down the campo. So you've got the inside-outside attack, which is so critical when you're playing against a team that is supposed to be defensive-oriented.
Foul laban kay Ryan Reyes, kanyang pangatlong personal foul. Yan po ang second team foul laban sa Talking Text. Arwin Santos with 12 points tonight. Pero lamang pa rin ang Talking Text, 58-51. Here's Castro. Castro, one-on-one against Danny Ai. Castro uses his speed. Peña helps out. You know, it takes a lot of guile and a lot of guts for a guard to go inside the lane against Danny Ai and Dorian Peña.
You know, you will concede that he might be able to get away from his man from up high.
Yeah, because he's bilis.
And because of his dribble drives, his head fakes, his shuffle movement, his crossover. But when you're able to get that close to the basket and fake off two, three defenders, I mean, something's wrong with your defense. You need to make major adjustments now because your last line of defense is not holding strong. And that's San Miguel's trump card. They've got to play with good defense to win this game.
Seven and a half remaining dito sa third quarter. Score natin 59-51. Labang pa rin ang Talking Text. Ball na nakikabag doon. Breakdown move. Danny Ildefonso connects.
Alex Cabagnon again with the feed. Right now, I think Alex Cabagnon wants to be able to boost the confidence level of his teammates. That's why he's dishing off. He wants the guys to get open and feel comfortable taking shots. That's the mark of a leader. That's what he needs to do because that's exactly what Jimmy Alapag did for Talking Text in the second quarter.
Here's Ontiveros. As we near the halfway mark of the third quarter, Arwin Santos on the right side for three. In and out. Battle for the rebound. Nakuha ni Daniel Defonso. Bagong shot clock para sa San Miguel. Danny Ai wants that ball against Rani Del Dio Capo. Daniel Defonso spins, gives it up. Arwin Santos scores. And slowly, San Miguel climbing back in this ball game. They have to relinquishing that lead. Talking Text, lamang ng apat. Mr. Robert Non, of course, of the San Miguel group. Jody Vance of the Alaska Aces. And close to 15,000 fans are inside the Araneta Coliseum. Chapit Aguilar of the Smart Gilas team also in attendance tonight. Bola ngayon na kay Castro. Talking Text up by four here in the third quarter of game number five. This series is tied at two games apiece. Alapag has played big tonight. Nice pass para kay Ali P.
San Miguel forced to foul because that ball was already in the shaded area, scoring position for Ali P.
Si Ontiveros ang tinawagan ng foul. Penalty na po ang San Miguel. That will be the second personal laban kay Ontiveros.
Now, by the way, kani-kanina lamang, no? Inupo ni Coach Chot Reyes, si Ryan Reyes, and he put in Kelly Williams in exchange. And I think the reason being that Arwin Santos is starting to wax hot, especially from around the shaded area, and he wants a tougher defender on him. I have a feeling that Kelly Williams is going to take on Arwin Santos. Let's see how the defensive matchups go. But Kelly Williams is far away from him.
It's Harvey Carey and Arwin Santos.
But I think, but I think that's just because of the motion that San Miguel played. Let's see how the defensive alignments are going to be once San Miguel sets up in the half court.